Hello students, looking at current affairs for 6th May. So the important keywords which have been picked up from today's newspaper are given here. You can see first one is regarding stranded Indians abroad. Now we saw this yesterday too. It was said stranded Indians abroad will be brought back to the country. They'll be returning. But now the news is that they will be charged commercial fares by Air India for their flight tickets. Plus also they'll have to pay the hospital charges where they will have to stay and the quarantine facility charges. So all those would be procured from them. So government is not going to chip in. Then second is the resistance front, TRF. So this is a new terrorist organization which has cropped in Jammu and Kashmir. It is said to be a local terrorist group, but government claims this is actually a farce, a garb being used by Pakistan. Indian government claims that it is supported by Pakistan, and instead of using ISI and Hizbul Mujahideen, instead of using Hizbul Mujahideen, what Pakistan intelligence ISI is doing now, it has set up a new organization so that it can come out clean in FATF. FATF is Financial Action Task Force. So this is an international organization on money laundering and terror financing. And Pakistan has already been grey listed by FATF. So to ensure that no adverse effect comes to it, it's said to be supporting the resistance front, a new terror organization. Recently, the news had come of soldiers being killed in Jammu and Kashmir, including a general, and TRF is claimed responsibility for it. Then next is regarding North Korea Russia relations. So this is the Cold War era history which you should know about. Plus also recently the Russian President Vladimir Putin has commemorated North Korean leader Kim Jong-un with a war memorial medal, war medal as such. So commemorating 75th anniversary of defeat of Nazi Germany as such. Then next is during the World War II. The next is Tiangong. So Tiangong is a space station of China. So it's complete progress. Tiangong 1, Tiangong 2 has been completely covered here. What is the timeline? And next comes Toman. So Toman is Iran's new currency. So Iran's currency is rial. Now it has been given a new valuation. So Toman is the name which has been given to the new Iranian currency. It's actually an old currency in use too. The word has been in use earlier too for Iran's currency. And now this Toman will be equal to, one Toman is equal to 10,000 riyals. So four zeros brought down in Iranian currency. So this is required because inflation in Iran and the exchange rate of Iranian currency has gone completely out of hands. And lastly, you have regarding Pulitzer Prize. Recently, even Indian journalists have received Pulitzer Prize. And another term which comes with Pulitzer Prize is yellow journalism. So you should know what is yellow journalism. Basically, it is sensational journalism. So we'll look about that too. So let's start with it. So we upload our current affairs on our website, aashar.com. And here you have the important headlines which have been picked up from the Hindu newspaper. These are the 8 important headlines. And the first one is, India records another spike with 3,875 new cases, 194 deaths. So this is, again, every day we come up with the number of new cases and number of deaths. And this is a huge spike which is being seen here, you can see, on May 5. The number of deaths and the number of new cases. Then this, you can see, West Bengal accounted for bulk of the fatality. 72 deaths took place in West Bengal itself. Then next is Air India to charge commercial fares from stranded Indians. So we have seen in phases, in stranded Indians will be returning to the country starting from May 7, tomorrow. And Indian citizens first would be returning from Gulf and Southeast Asian nations. So as well as from countries like US and other countries. So they will have to pay commercial fares to Air India, and Air India can charge up to 1 lakh per ticket. So that is it. So depending on the place where you're coming from, like flights from Dubai will cost 13,000, Abu Dhabi 15,000, and so on. Flights from US, Chicago, San Francisco, Washington will cost nearly 1 lakh. And some of the flights from India, it is said, may also ferry foreign nationals. And passengers will also have to pay for the quarantine facilities on their return. The next is TRF, a ploy by Pakistan to avoid scrutiny, says Jammu and Kashmir's DGP. So the Resistance Front TRF had claimed responsibility for attacks carried out as such on April 5 along the LOC in Kupwara sector, where five army personnel were killed. And security agencies say this was TRF has been formed to help Pakistan evade scrutiny by FATF, Financial Action Task Force, to avoid further sanctions. Because as we saw, it has already been grey listed. So FATF also we discussed, it is a global money laundering and terror financing watchdog. So Pakistan already is grey listed, and its further review will take place in a meeting in Beijing in June 2020. And TRF is linked to Pakistan terrorist groups like Hizbul Mujahideen is evident because TRF also includes members of Hizbul Mujahideen. So this is the name change, TRF as it is called, the Resistance Front. So it is said similar strategy was used by Pakistan in Myanmar too, where it promoted extremism among Rohingyas and kept appealing to Western countries regarding it. So rebranding terror groups in Kashmir. And this is regarding FATF, an intergovernmental body created in 1989 by G7, the Group of Seven Developed Nations. And it sets standards, develops, and promotes policies to combat money laundering and terror financing. So it gives recommendations. And you can see it was established in 1989, and it took over, it was basically for money laundering, and it took over the responsibility of fight against terror financing in 2001 after the terror attacks, the 9/11 terror attacks of 2001. And this is regarding how Pakistan has been grey listed. So how this grey list hurts Pakistan, because its economy as well as international standing gets hurt. China is the one which has supported Pakistan, and it has defended Pakistan as such on this issue too. And it says that Pakistan is also making attempts to fight terrorism. Pakistan also claims and plays the victim card, saying it itself is suffering from terrorism. But you can see Pakistan has been grey listed. You can see in June 2018, and this listing as such, you can see, means downgrading of the country by multilateral lenders like IMF, World Bank, Asian Development Bank, even EU as such downgrades it, and there's risk rating by Moody's, S&P, and Fitch also, which are adverse. So this from June 2018 again, Pakistan has been continues to stay in the grey list as such till Feb 2022, and it continues to be under it. Feb 2020 was when Pakistan had to finally deliver another report on action plan, what steps it has taken to counter terror financing and money laundering. So it few has been blacklisted too, but so far it has been grey listed. The next is Ramesh withdraws plea in Supreme Court, writes to Paswan. So yesterday in news we saw that former Union Minister Jairam Ramesh had filed a petition in the Supreme Court claiming that even people who do not have ration cards should get food under the PDS, public distribution system. He had sought a non-discriminatory implementation of National Food Security Act. But then now the court had asked the ministers, the government, to respond, and within hours of this petition, government has assured the Supreme Court that the concerns of Mr. Jairam Ramesh would be duly attended to. And Jairam Ramesh side also went on to acknowledge that they had come directly to the court without approaching the government first. So now the court has allowed him to withdraw the petition. And now Jairam Ramesh has given a detailed representation to Union Minister of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution, Ramvilas Paswan, raising his concerns about how public distribution system and food security for poor have to be clamped up so that there are no sufferings and starvation deaths. So he has asked the government to ensure that food grains were not denied to those who did not produce ration cards during the lockdown. The next is Putin honors Kim with war medal. So Russian President Vladimir Putin has awarded Kim Jong-un a commemorative war medal marking 75th anniversary of the victory over Nazi Germany. So this medal has been awarded to Mr. Kim for his role in preserving the memory of even Soviet soldiers who died in North Korean territory at that time. So this is, you can see, about the Cold War era. So this is the border between Russia and North Korea presently too. You can see. And it was in 1945 when Japanese army surrendered after World War II, and USA announced its intention to occupy South Korea. Korea was one single nation territory, and the south of it, south of the 38th parallel, was occupied by USA. So Soviet Union occupied the northern part. So that's how two nations, North Korea and South Korea, have been separated. And then in 1950, North Korea invaded South Korea, and this triggered Korean War. So armistice agreement has been signed, which ended 36 months of brutal combat between the two Koreas. But as it is said, it's just an armistice agreement. It is not end of war which has been declared so yet. So that is also a concern. We have been seeing how US and North Korea have had been having talks under President Trump. Earlier in 2002, President Bush had named North Korea as an axis of evil along with Iran and Iraq that supports terrorism and seeks weapons of mass destruction. And North Korea was operating a secret nuclear weapons program as such, and it continues to test nuclear weapons as such, and demands funds from US government, support from US government, otherwise it threatens that it would conduct nuclear tests and tests as such. So that is the basic policy which North Korea uses. President Trump had talks with North Korea, but they did not succeed. Even Russian President Vladimir Putin and Kim summit took place. You can see this was on April 25th of 2018. So you can see this was before the talks which took place. After the talks which took place between US President Donald Trump and Kim Jong-un, the Hanoi meeting which took place, which resulted in no solution. So after that, Putin-Kim summit took place. So basically, negotiations are called for to end North Korea's nuclear program. So denuclearization of the Korean Peninsula is what is being sought, and the negotiations basically are that North Korea demands that sanctions which have been imposed against it by USA and developed and the international sanctions as such, they should be removed, and it would go for denuclearization. But Trump insisted that no, there should be denuclearization first, and then we'll provide then we'll remove sanctions. So that resulted in a deadlock, a standoff, and the talks failed. But Kim-Putin relations are good. You can see they had a summit too. You can see the relation in trade terms too. Russian exports to North Korea are huge. Even North Korea's exports to Russia are meager compared to imports. So it's $1.98 million of exports to Russia. And 70% of this is musical instruments. It's a fact which is given here. Then next is China launches new rocket spacecraft. So China has successfully launched a new rocket and prototype spacecraft in a major test of the country's ambitions to operate a permanent space station and send astronauts to the moon. So far, US is the only country which has successfully sent humans to the moon, and China wants to achieve this feat too, and it has this rocket Long March 5B has been used. Presently it took off from Wenchang launch site of China, and it had an unmanned prototype spaceship which successfully separated from the rocket too and entered into its planned orbit. So this was a test version of a cargo return capsule. So test version of that also separated from the rocket. So both you can see this was, one was prototype spaceship and a cargo return capsule, both were used on the rocket, and they were successfully completed their task. So what China is basically planning is a space station. So this is called Tiangong space station. Assembly of this is expected to begin in 2020 and finish in 2022. Already China has experimented Tiangong 1, Tiangong 2 have already been launched. So this is the Long March rocket of Russia. Compared to other rockets from various countries. And this is the launch site, Wenchang Space Station in China. And this is the first space station module, Tiangong 1, which was planned and which was put in space as such too. In comparing this space station planned by China with other space stations like in ISS, International Space Station, how much it weighs and how much is its length. And also this is the mid space station of Russia, which is not functional presently. It was in function from 1986 to 2001. And ISS has been in operation since 1988, and it has been there, it will be there till 2020, extended till 2028 now. And Chinese space station is set to be in place by 2023, completely assembled. So it would be much smaller compared to ISS and Mir. It would be weighing 90 tons, though its spread is more than Mir, you can see. So this is Tiangong 1. It was launched in 2011. It basically means heavenly palace, Tiangong, or celestial palace. So it also had, China also had first inhabited mission in 2012. But then in 2016, China lost control of the station and it returned into atmosphere. Then we had Tiangong 2, which also was launched by China, but then it also was controlled in a controlled manner. After it has completed its objective, it was safe landed on Earth. Next is, amid high inflation, Iran to get a new currency. So for many years, Iran's government has been debating that it wants to change its national currency, that is the rial. And what it wants is slash four zeros at the end of it. Means 10,000 rials. So these four zeros should be cut down, means each 10,000 rials means one toman under this new system. So this is because American sanctions and economic mismanagement, it is said, have contributed to inflation in Iran, and its currency has spiraled in negative. So Iranian parliament also has taken steps authorizing the replacement of rial with another basic unit of currency called toman. And value of Iran's currency, it is said, fell by roughly 60%. So Iranian central bank will have 2 years to implement the change, that is removing old rials. And this devaluation as such has been done earlier too. It is not the first time that it has been done. In 2020, currency had been devalued 3,500 times as such since 1971. And Iran presently had no choice but to save the face, because rial's exchange rate was 1,56,000 rials you have to pay for getting $1. So that's the exchange rate, which is of course unmanageable. So government continues to maintain exchange rate at a particular level, but you know, in the markets, the exchange rate has fallen drastically. So this depends on the demand for the currency as such. So this is Iranian rial, which has been replaced by toman. Toman was a value which was used earlier too. It was called 1/8 as such. So 1/8 of it was of dinar as such. So now it has been, one toman is not 10 rials as earlier, but one toman is now 10,000 rials. And the last news is, three Indian photographers win Pulitzer Prize. So 2020 Pulitzer Prize winners were announced. They were announced virtually as such, and New York Times picked up the most awards. Indian is also involved here. You can see three photographers were named for the award for their feature photographic category for images showing life in Kashmir as India revoked its semi-autonomous status. So this image also won the Pulitzer Prize, an injured Kashmiri girl. So who was this Joseph Pulitzer? You should know about it too, after whom the prize is named. Even books are awarded Pulitzer Prize, and this is regarding journalism and photojournalism too. So he himself was a journalist, and he liked to present news with sensationalism. So this, when education spread, and contributed to rapid growth in American newspapers. Then came the printing press too, which resulted in cost of newspaper coming down drastically. So he cut the costs too. And he was the first modern mass having the owning the first modern mass circulation newspaper. So his papers were famous for their sensational headlines. It reported crimes and scandals. So critics call Pulitzer's type of journalism as yellow journalism. Means sensationalist news that focuses on crime and sexual content, also known as tabloid journalism. So that is it. Thank you.